Hey, it's Jin. Reviewing this Shocker Beefcake. I noticed there's no review for it on all of YouTube. There's actually no real video besides the initial preview that guy had, I think, at Comic-Con. I just spent a couple hours sanding out some rough patches. You can see it's a lot smoother here. His other forearm too. He had a seam going up either end that cuts across each hand. This fist right here was completely demolished. I had re-sculpted all those. They just kind of carved him in with my X-Acto so that I put his pinky and his thumb back in place. That was just a solid ball. We couldn't really see any fingers there. Over here, you can see he's got a little work still on the nails to do. I cleaned up all of these scratches, battle damage on his armor. Just looked like somebody dragged a pen over the clay. It was just very poor sculpting. And I fixed his teeth too, try to get a really good close on his mouth. They were just crooked and all over the place. I straightened him out and re-sculpted him in. Fixed his lip too, so you can see he's got a lip, then his bottom teeth and his top teeth. And all of these, I had to retouch every single spike on all of his helmet and his suit. All of them had air bubbles in the mold, and you can see he tried to patch them. I'm just using he in general because Shocker, you know. This is really solid too, kind of big. It's almost like a 12 inch figure. I don't even remember how tall they said exactly. They're supposed to be 10 or shorter, but he actually looks a lot bigger. And this is really solid and heavy too. When I saw one of these the first time during the war party or GWAR tour, probably 2006 or 2007, they had a really hollowed out version. It was really light. And this guy's completely solid. And another thing, when it was mailed out, when I first got it, he was primed in gray, and I just covered him in white. You can see all his detail a little better. Poor sculpting on with fur in the back. I like that little skull knuckles. You can see he's got a tiny little earring right there in his ear. Got this ear pierced too. Overall, it could be cool. With some work, it could be a really interesting figure. Big monster feet. The only thing I don't like are these. Each little panel is glued on separate. You can see they don't exactly all go up to the belt, but just knocking one of these a little bit, I can't hold him here at his waist. I gotta hold him really far down at his feet, or up here at his waist, or just grab him around the chest. But if you touch these, they're gonna break off, all of these little spikes. He's a very delicate statue. I'm not even gonna call him a figure or toy anymore. He's a statue. There you can see, looks like a okay, Jinlixor, this is my review for Beefcake. I'll probably post another video once he's all the way painted, so you can see. That's it.